G'day chaps and welcome back. This is episode 4 of The Long Dark. We are climbing Timberwolf Mountain. I've managed to get my weight just under the 40 kilos I need to get it to get up this mountain. We have point one of a kg. Oh, I'm going to fill it. There we go. We are right on the nose of 40k. Let's just make sure we can actually get up this thing. This could completely exhaust us because we're as heavy as we could possibly be. So I've basically tested to give you the background, and anything above 40 kilos means that you can't climb this rope at all. It's just too much. Whereas 40 kilos seems to be the limit. Okay, so we did it and we had a fair amount of puff left over. Okay, here we are. We are a level higher. Now, just gonna make sure we don't run into any wolves around here. The one thing I had to drop most of is water, so I have under a liter of water. I'm not too thirsty just yet, but I'm gonna need to pick up some sticks along the way. I'm gonna pick up sticks because they're the smallest and they're the quickest to grab. You don't need to stop and break anything down. So I'm just gonna collect as many sticks as I can. The rest of the food, you'll notice we lost the meat we were carrying. That's because that's very, very heavy relative to how many calories it gives you. It's also a renewable resource, which means that we can find and harvest it anywhere we like. As long as we can take an animal down, and as we're pretty well kitted out, that's not too difficult. You'll notice I'm only picking the rose bush. Oh crap. Okay. Ooh, close. That'll be our dinner. Yes, you are our dinner. Thank you very much. And there is a deer down there too. We may prefer deer meat to wolf meat, but I'll take this anyway just because we're here. Let's go for all the round number, 3 kilos. 9 hours of daylight left. Let's see, okay, we've still got plenty of energy. I can see aircraft holding whatever they're called. Cargo things up ahead. Here's our deer. Now if this deer isn't too damaged or frozen, you see it was a good idea to have that torch out. Proves the theory. If this is still pretty fresh, I will take more of the deer meat and drop the... yeah, this is fresh. So I'm going to take 4 kilos of this. I'm going to drop the wolf meat probably, because it's less calorific. So it's the deer meat that's slightly better. How heavy are we? We're never going to need all this meat, so I'm just going to drop the wolf meat. We need to focus more on getting more sticks so we can cook all this. I can see those saplings up ahead. They will be very, very valuable and very worthwhile collecting on the way back down, but not for now, not while we're trying to get up. I'm going to check out these cargo boxes. That's what they're called, cargo boxes. Just checking around to see if there aren't any more wolves. There's a deer down there, which is good. If there are deer, that means there are no wolves. I'm tempted to check around this rock before I open this, but I want to see what's in it. Let's have a little look-see. There isn't much I can carry, remember, so let's see what we get. Ooh. Well, that's useful. That's not useful. Ah, it's just rabbits.
I could use this.
I can't actually use that. So ignore what Will's saying. Will's my character. He's saying we can use that leather. We can't, because we've got no boots to repair. There's nothing we can do with it, so I guess I'll drop it by those saplings over there so that when I make my way back over here, at some point, hopefully on the way back down. But we don't even know if we're going to come back down the same way we're coming up. I don't know. So the least I can do is just drop them next to that those saplings, because I know that if I do come back through here, I will definitely go and harvest them, because I'll be on the way back down, and I'll want them as a resource. And if I'm heading back down, by then I should know my way, and if I need to carry a lot of stuff, I can do relays to get it back down the road. Relays and rest. I thought I saw a wolf, but it wasn't. It was a tree stump. Ooh, 7 hours of daylight, and we're very, very tired. Okay. We're more tired than I thought we were going to be. So the daylight's not really the issue, but that tiredness is. That means that essentially if we're that tired already, we're probably not going to be able to climb the next rope without sleeping. So I'm just picking up all the sticks I can. There are two kinds of saplings down here. Looks like there's nothing else for me to really collect apart from sticks. I can get those sticks from down the bottom. So it looks to be safe enough. I've killed that wolf and there's a deer down there. If there's a deer, then it means I'm okay. I can see more rose bush up ahead. Right, so I'm just going to collect all these sticks. It's interesting, I've started noticing a little, I don't know if you can see it or not, a little juttering, like in the frame rate. Yeah, it's a deer. Okay, so I'm gonna, let's drop what we were gonna drop. Oh, that leather. Where is it? There. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I'm not gonna need all of these. I'll repair my mittens, but that only takes one, so I'll drop 5. And sticks we need, tinder we need. I'm keeping the rose hips so that we can make more medicine. It's this. It works as a painkiller, natural painkiller there. Okay. Is that? Yeah, that's obvious. We're not going to miss that when we come back through. So, let's keep on collecting these sticks. We need some place to rest. And once we find somewhere to rest, then we can gather proper wood by chopping one of these logs. Oh, there's some more natural tinder here. This stuff's good, birch bark, because it's very, very light. We've actually got loads of tinder at the moment. So, ooh. Ah. See that up ahead? See that there? That's a cave. Deer clearing. That sounds promising. That means that it's unlikely to be very dangerous. I would take him down, but I don't need the meat. I should save the bullets. But we'll take these rose bush though, because that means we can make a bit more medicine for ourselves in case we need the painkillers in case of sprains. And sprains are actually quite common. If you're walking along any kind of angle, you're quite likely to get a sprain. Okay, there looks to be another one just next to the entrance of the cave. So, I think we're pretty good weight-wise. Yeah, 46. We're not going to be too tired or slow. I wonder where we go next. So I reckon this is probably supposed to be our resting place, because it's pretty safe. You know, a place called Deer Clearing. There's wood and things like that. I reckon this is as good a place as we're gonna get to sleep in, because we do need rest, and we're not gonna be able to recharge this energy without sleeping, I don't know, at least 5 hours, so we're basically going to have to spend the night here. And hope it's safe. I do have the bear skin. Ah, there's more wood. Oh, good. Oh, I guess this is where we're sleeping now. That's cedar. Yeah. So I'm going to drop the meat here. 1, 2, 3, 4, keep all the rest on me. Don't need to worry about it. I don't want to drop gear and then pick it up and try and sort through it all, so I'm just going to keep it. Yeah. We're not too heavy anymore. So that's where we're going to sleep. Just need to go and get some wood now. It seems to be pretty plentiful. What do we have here? That's just perfect. We'll be able to chop this up for sure. That looks to me like fir wood, which is it? No, cedar. Oh, but it's a big one, so we get 5 out of there, but that'll be more than enough. That's more than enough, so we don't need to worry about wood. We're probably going to have too many tinder now. And the tinder we have is kind of heavy, so... Oh no. Same weight. Okay. Guess we take it anyway, we can always drop it. Oh wow, it's getting dark. 5 hours of daylight left and it's already getting dark. We need to eat and drink pretty soon. Beautiful scenery in this game. Absolutely stunning. So this is going to be what it's like to sleep rough, wild, on the side of a mountain, boys. Let's hope we don't get woken up by growling, because that could pretty much suck. I reckon when we get up, we're going to go left. That seems to be a pretty natural route. I guess, I don't know. Maybe we go back along and then continue along the sort of gap type ravine we found. Yeah. We'll see. Let's get some sleep first. Get ourselves all sorted. So we're going to cook up our meat. We're going to try and cook up our roast hip. Gotta grab it all. Be nice if there was an option to grab everything. Not that it's not a big deal. So I'm gonna... Let's get cozy. Let's get real nice and comfortable. Big, heavy, comfortable bearskin rug. Put it right there. Let's get our fire going. Let's crouch down first. Set the Atmos. Let's get right by our bearskin. Be nice and comfortable. We want to put the fire in front of us so that any bear is deterred. Yep, we'll burn the birch bark, tinder plug. Yep, 100% chance of success. Sounds good to me. I think we've got enough matches. I took 40. And then we have the fire striker, which you can use to light fires in anything. So that's our backup, and that's nearly at 100%. So I don't think we need to worry about being able to start fires at any point. It's more about when do we do it, where do we do it, is it the right thing, right time to do it, are we using our resources in exactly the right way, could we be doing anything more efficiently, that kind of stuff. It's very much that kind of game. I'm going to add all the sticks. I'm going to get rid of any torches that aren't 100%, they're all pretty much 100%. I'm going to take another torch, so that I tend to keep 5 as a rule, and then I'm going to cook up the first meat we have. I don't know if we're going to need to use all the wood we have. Let's just see. Actually, I reckon we will have to use it all. We may as well. Not only does it make it us warmer, but it's going to deter any animals. Yeah, we want to get as much sleep as we can while the fire's going, I guess. Increase our chances of survival. I do think, though, I mean, we are in a place called Deer... whatever it was. Right, we need to eat. Deer Clearing. It does suggest that it's pretty much a haven for deer. Yeah. So we got tons of food now. Look, we've got 3 whole kilos of meat. And a bunch of other stuff. Let's see if we can't cook up these... rose hips we have. Oh yeah, and we need to repair our mittens we have. Let's cook this up first. Rose hip cook. There we go. So this is a natural painkiller we can make as we go, and if we start getting heavy we can drop it and we've lost nothing. so that's why I'm making that. Okay. I'm going to do this little repair. Again, this is to get the weight down, so rabbit skin mitts. We win a tiny bit by repairing them. Oh, crap. Oh, we need gut. Ah, oh, crap. Okay. I didn't bring any gut. And which makes these pelts useless. We're going to have to go back and drop them where we dropped the others then. We don't have enough rosehip to make any more tea with it, so I think it's just time to make water. I'm going to put it all on. There we go. Six, nearly 7 hours we get. So I reckon we could... We don't need that much. I reckon we could go 3 liters of water. And then we can start sleeping. And... I don't know, maybe just nap the rest of it. I don't know if that'll actually help against bears. You have to sleep an hour each time, minimum. I don't really want to set off before daylight, because that'll make things even more dangerous. Let's just see. Pretty tired now. So we've got 3 kilos of water. I don't think we're going to need any more than that at all. I'm going to get a couple hours sleep while we can, while the fire's burning. Let's see what it's like being in this cave at night. Kind of scary. Damn, look at that. How's that for a view? Huh. Let's actually make a really cool video cover. I'm gonna take a screenshot. There you go. Also make kind of a cool entrance to the a cool intro to the whole series, really. Watching the fire like that. I guess it doesn't really say Timberwolf Mountain though, does it? Anyway, very, very cool. 3 hours left. And this is good because it's all dropping our weight too, so we're getting back under 40 kilos. And we're getting back under 40 kilos while we have lots of food and drink. Excellent. So we've got 3 hours there. 10 hours of darkness left. I reckon we just... What can we do? Let's just go for a big sleep. Hope we don't get woken up by growling. Which is... Oh man, I don't like this. Okay. It's quiet. There's the entrance. We're fully rested. We made it this far. Sounds pretty windy out there. I really don't want to go out in this weather. But I'm nervous to sleep anymore. The fire's burned out, we've got no more fuel. Let's just, I'm gonna go for 3 hours, let's just hope. If we can sleep these 3 hours in peace, we can go again for a whole other day. And that'll make our next episode. And we're all quiet, we're good. Okay. We made it. A new dawn. On the mountain. Very exciting indeed. Here we are. I can hear deer. Wow, look how peaceful this is. Absolutely quiet and peaceful. We just spent the night on the side of a mountain by ourselves. End of the world scenario. Ladies and gentlemen. The Long Dark. Truly fantastic game. Look at that. I love the art style of this game. I truly do. Okay, we have enough water, more or less. Oh, I need to put that rabbit pelt back where I found it. And then we figure out where we go next. It's the dawn of a new day. It's 2 degrees. We're warm enough. We have food. We have weapons. This is a cool little... I'm enjoying this series so far, boys. I really am. I hope you are. This is exactly what I wanted. So I'd been here once before I'd started a game on Timberwolf Mountain. And I spent my whole time just clinging to life, you know? Barely surviving. So to be here, warm, fed, with weapons, the whole deal, feels all the more special to me. I'm still on my guard though, so I'm going to keep the defenses up. So this is where we dropped our pelt. So I'm going to pop it here. We're just about at that 20 minute mark. Boys. There we go, I've dropped that. So I reckon it's time to kind of stop it here. And I'll see you again in episode 5, where we find the next rope and head up to the next level of Timberwolf Mountain. As always, if you're interested in seeing your names in the credits, consider support me on Patreon. And there's a link to my Patreon page from the channel page, if you're interested in that. Either way, whether you support me or not, I thank you very much for watching. It's always a pleasure. And I will see you in the next one. Ciao for now, boys.